What's up? What's up? What's up? Welcome to day 302, Make It Songbringer. And, well, today I'm going to work on the main menu. yeah, it's been like some really great days here. Lots of wizardry going on in the code, simplifying things. I'm learning about Git too. So I'm working on having a single branch called Fun. And then another branch called Master. So whenever I want to do work that I don't want to affect the Steam version, the release version, I just work on the Fun branch. And then when I want to go check some stuff back into Master, I can. I can go switch back to Master, and basically that's like my release branch. So that's going to make it way easier to update the Steam a lot faster. Oh, you know what? I forgot about my chat menu. Sorry.
Chat window.
Close out the kung fu. Turn on the chat. Here we go. Oh, what's this noise? What the? It's playing the video. Stop the video. How do I get rid of the video on this? Mighty Nest, did you just communicate just now, or is that from before? Mighty Nest, Hardboiled, what's up? You guys are here. What's up, Hardboiled, Mighty Nest, and Arcane? Yeah, so Mighty Nest, Wiz emailed you, isn't working. Want to know if you have a finalized script for beta for us to translate. When did you send the email? Because I just tried to fix it last night. My server didn't have some IPv6 settings or whatever. So you just tried just now? It might have, it said last night that it would take like up to 24 hours. If you want, you could DM me on Twitter and tell me what your error was. Unless you just want to look it up right now, you could tell me what if your error. It was a couple of days ago. Okay, yeah, it was definitely broken then. Yeah, so I just fixed it last night, and they said it might take up to 24 hours to fix this. So hopefully my email will be fixed after that, and there's no weird issues. I don't know why it didn't. It's a really picky thing, is this IPv6 reverse DNS thing. What's up, Pedro? Yeah, sorry about the late stream. I've had a really busy morning. I've been trying to learn about Git for like the last... If anybody's a Git wizard, I have a Git question on Stack Overflow right now. Oh, look, I actually got an upvote. I'll post this here in the chat if anybody has any idea. How many lines in the code so far? Let's see. 46,000. I think I've been doing pretty good. Lately I have not been adding that much code. I want to get less code if possible. You know, if I could shave off 7,000 lines off of that, that would be really cool. You know, just to make things more data driven. Yeah, so once again, hopefully that email problem is fixed up by tonight. It probably is fixed already. If anybody's emailing me right now, you'll probably be fine. And it was only with some people's hosts. Like especially if you're Hotmail. If you're Hotmail, it was like guaranteed to give you a bug. So what I want to work on today, how many lines per day I actually code. See, it'd be hard to determine at this point because so a lot of times I'm coding stuff and writing a bunch of code and then taking away old code. You know, it's a lot of refactoring that's going on at this point because the project's already pretty mature. But I would guess on average I write at least 500 to 1,000 new lines of code. I don't know, maybe less. What's up, Forever Classic? So yeah, what I'm saying here is today I'm working on the menu. I'm gonna go in and make it so the menu has the feature to change your window mode. Like you can go from windowed mode to full screen and some other options like music volume, sound volume. So I'm gonna be in here in this screen right here. So I'm gonna start adding some options. Like, we'll start with windowed mode, volume, for those two things. Yeah, that's what I'm working on today. So hopefully I can, basically I was talking about having a fun branch and a master branch. And basically this will be committed to the master branch, so I can go, yeah, I can actually write hardboiled. I can actually finally update this to Steam pretty easily because I have this master branch, which is like the release branch. So I can keep things separate. I can do the fun, new creative things for like new dungeons in the fun branch, and then easily switch back to my master branch and push up to Steam. So this is something that will actually go into the Steam branch. But for now, I'm just on... Actually, you know what? Let's do this right on master. Yeah, let's switch back to master and do all these changes here. Yeah, you always use source tree. Yeah, I'm always trying to use the command line just so that I know what's going on. I want to understand what's going on. So it's been a really good exploration this morning. Oh, I have to rebuild. Damn it. That's right. Okay, well, start rebuilding. But yeah, it's been some really good exploration and learning this morning. I really understood what, I started understanding what remotes are better this morning, you know, and what references are, refs. What the heck is a git ref? What's a blob? What's origin? You know, all these things. I basically did not understand how Git really worked until today. I still don't. I still really need to read the manual, you know. And Git SCM actually has a really good thing. If anybody wants to learn more about Git, Git SCM has a great documentation. And this book, if you go to Git SCM, which is the official Git website, and then you go to documentation book, this book is pretty rad. It's really simple. Lots of short, little, simple, you know, explanations. All right, so while that's building, somebody will know what this is. A pretty simple thing. Okay, so while this is building, I'll start coding up some stuff for the main menu. Would be great to see if old bugs are actually fixed and new bugs pop up. Yeah, definitely. Definitely, yeah. I'm really looking forward to having this new setup. So it hopefully makes it easier for me to push updates to Steam to you guys faster. When I went to software engineering class, we're told that statistically you were able to write 1,000 bug-free lines of code per year. That's 5.5 per day. Wow. That's kind of crazy. It's probably true. And it probably depends on the programmer, you know, the strength of the programmer is how many bug-free lines of code you write per year. Adrian, but I did want to throw out that I'm a writer for Giga Geek magazine and wanted to thank you for keeping in contact with us. All right, sweet, forever. Nice, man. Yeah. How's it going? Anything I can do for you guys? Did you get the? You got your Steam code, right? If you need more Steam codes, if you want to give away some more Steam codes to your readers, just email me. I'd love to be able to do that for you guys. It might be fun to do a little giveaway or something. And this is also for you guys right now. This is the alpha version, which means that it's basically the equivalent of somebody backing the Kickstarter, which was back in May, backing the Kickstarter at like $64. So it's a pretty good value that you're getting out of these free Steam codes right now. You'll be happy for Steam codes too? Yeah. You can win them. You can win them right here on the stream using your points. Okay, so I've got my setup, so I can go into show the frame rate, skip straight to the menu. Let's do that. So I should be able to run this now. Now it'll skip straight to the menu, and I can do this work to add the windowed mode. Awesome, you got it installed perfectly. You just have been snowed in. All right. All right, cool. Yeah. All right, man. Well, I'm here if you need anything, and hope you enjoy the game. You got 532 points. It's pretty good. It's only 1,000. What is it? 1,000 whatever to have the raffle? How's the raffle work now? Yeah, the more I think, I don't know exactly if Boogie finished the feature, but I think that we decided in general that it will be, yeah, 1,000 points is the minimum or something like that to raffle, and then every point more than that you use, you'll get more of a percentage of chance to win. Oh, there's Boogie. Boogie, what's up, man? We're wondering exactly how the new points, the raffle works. Is it still the old way? Dang, Arcane, nice. Okay, so I want to add a window option right here. Okay, cool. Nice. Okay, cool. Well, then, so hard-boiled, it's still the old way, yeah. So, but which is still a cool way. You know, like, basically, you at 1,000 points, you raffle, and... yeah, Salad Dong's right. The game looks a lot better at 60 frames a second. You know, my apologies that I can't stream and run the game at 30 frames a second, and let alone stream at 60 frames a second, which would be kill my internet connection, my weak ass Comcast internet connection. Jeez, man, they just like halved the upload rate recently or something. It's just horrible. Okay, so I keep talking. I want to get back into what function is it that I want to go to and create more? The settings menu. We want some more options here, some choices. You finished the witness already? What can you use the points for? You can get the game or stickers. Well, actually just the game right now, a Steam code. The ending was weird. So I'm going to add a choice for window. Window size. Yeah, let's start adding some strings to the English. Felt a void. There isn't any story. What did the witness? Menu. All right, so we're gonna have some more strings here in the menu. Menu settings, window. Menu option. Okay, so we're gonna have full screen is the default. Let's make this mixed case. There we go. So we got window full screen. Full screen. This is fine. Option full screen. Option borderless. Which is a full screen window, borderless. Borderless. If you guys have any ideas too, if I should name this the full screen windowed mode or borderless. If you guys have a better, simpler name for that, let me know. Another witness. Yes, you can. You can get Songbringer for points. So Arcane, right now, the way it would work is you could enter your points in for a chance to win. So you can trade 1,000 of your points to try and win the game. And if the raffle wins and you succeed, I think the chance right now, what's the chance? I don't know. I'm not exactly what the chance is that you'd win, but you'd win a Steam code. Key pause. All this is localized. So these are all strings that are localized. So, you know, like for example, there's the Portuguese translation. Or this, no, this is the Polish one, but there's also Portuguese. But anyways, this is translated. So these are just basically, it's localizing the strings. Menu option, full screen, borderless. What do we got? Let's go medium. Or just windowed. Window medium. What should I call this? Well, what we got for options again? Game, CPP. There's some options for when you for the menu or the. There it is. We got tiny, small, medium, movie. Basically, what that would be like. Man, I'm not sure what to add for options just yet. Windowed. I'm just gonna call it windowed for now. We do the tiny options later. Hundred days of farming points. Oh no! Oh, sorry, man. Sorry, Arcane. Damn. Boogie's a cheat. Why not give yourself millions? Right, if you were to get a cheat. So we got another options and stuff. Or menu settings. Music. Music volume. Sound volume. And those are going to be numbers, 1 through 10 or whatever. If I take damage holding down a movement key, I stop and have to let go of the key and repress it to start moving again. Oh, you know what? I haven't even taken a look at that, but I'll definitely add that to the Trello right now. I think I've seen that before too, Mighty Nest. And I would love to get other people's thoughts on that too, like Pedro, Boogie, Hardboiled, all you guys that have been playing the game a lot. Like, what do you prefer? If do you have you noticed that too when you get hit in the game and it makes you stop and have to let go of the key and repress it? Have you noticed that? What would you prefer? Getting hit, then you have to let go of. Oh. Get hit while holding a movement button, and you have to let go and repress. What's up, Steve Tramby? You can go back to Dark Souls and cry. Oh, Pedro likes it. Oh, Boogie's used to it. Hardball thinks you should be able to keep removing. All right, good. Got some good thoughts there. I think what I'll do is I'll try it out. I'll try out mo taking it out, and then, and then see how it feels. If it feels a lot better, I'm sure it'll be something I'll just keep in. So we got settings music, settings sound. Right, so this first one we want is menu settings. What was it, window? Yeah, window. Music and sound. Okay, so at this point, these aren't going to do anything at all, but at least they'll be in there, I think. Getting stopped from taking damage is fine, but it'll be smoother to continue moving again after a brief pause. I get you. I get you. Let me actually write down. That's a pretty good clarification to make. So let me add that to the Trello too. All right, good. We got these three options. They don't do anything yet. Cool. Write down what Ness is saying here. Getting stopped is fine, but if I'm holding a direction key, it shouldn't. Yeah, I think I agree with you here. I have to let go. Okay, so now I just need to make these do something. I think it gives a player a chance to decide if he tries to fight back or runs away. I vote keep it. All right, cool. You want to put your thoughts on there? Do you want to post to the Trello your comment there? That'd be nice to have your take on it too. So when I actually get to that, I'll remember what you said. Do you have a default set of settings, prefs, etc. baked into the game? Yes. Yeah, totally. If you bork up your settings or whatever, just delete them, make a backup or whatever, and then delete your settings and it will recreate. And it's right here in the game. It actually sets up some default settings. Where are these at? There it is. Yeah, so there's the default string of settings. Pretty simple. Okay. The way these are going to work, I want these to be able to use the left and right arrow keys. Let me get into the menu and I'll show you. Change for fun build, see how it feels. Yeah, well, that's the thing though. The fun build is the one here on my local system, but I see what you mean by master build is really what. What's up, baby? Hey, I'm streaming. I love you, baby. Oh, text me when you're flying and everything too, and also when you're supposed to arrive. All right. Okay, see you. All right, Ness, see you, man. right? Yeah. Getting stuck after taking damage. Just use a cactus. Alright, yeah, so right here, on these options right here, window, music, volume, sound, volume, all of these, I want you to be able to press the left and right arrow keys, and it will just change the option. So they're going to work differently. They need to have a different kind of callback. So that means choices need to be more flexible. This is the regular callback. Let's do some more callbacks. There's going to be a callback. There'll be a left callback and a right callback, or maybe just a... Why does it need the ref pointer to the callback? I probably should have a each. That would be something else. Good question, Steve. This ref obj, I'm not even using this ref. What does dot callback? Can I change around what this passes in the current choice? Yeah, I can totally do left and right. We'll change the options and passing in a different. What's this? Oh, that's, of course, that's the whole menu. Okay, yeah, I can safely change this now. Basically, I want a new function callback called option callback. This takes a ref pointer and a bool increase. So yeah, increase will be like take the current option and go one to the right. Decrease would be go one to the left. You got a response on the git problem? Sweet. I'd like to know what's up with that. Git Rebase made the copies. This is in fact how Git Rebase works. It makes copies because it must, because the new commits differ from the old ones. In this case, probably the only difference is that the new copies, which are in fact the pink ones shown lower down, point to commit blah, while the old ones point to commit blah. Merge went easily because the duplicates were duplicates, but now you've embedded both histories into the merge result. Both of these histories are now also copied to your remote repo. Can I upvote that? It's a good vote. Cool. Awesome. Yeah, I think I'm kind of understanding what he's saying here. I got to try all this out. So this is great. I'll try this out later and accept his answer probably. That's cool. I love Stack Overflow. And look, I'm only halfway done compiling. Dude. Make sure to have an accept button. There's nothing more annoying than changing the windowed mode resolution of a game and it's changing every single press. Well then I would have to redesign how this all works. So you would have the option to go into windowed mode and then it would have a windowed mode option screen. Well, but it doesn't actually change the resolution until you restart. Yeah, hard-boiled. I think it's okay because basically, when you're changing this windowed mode option, it's not applying any of the changes until you restart. So I'm pretty sure this is okay to keep as it is without an accept button because technically it doesn't accept until you restart the game. And there'll have to be some kind of like message about that. I mean, man, I guess I could do a different option for this or a totally different window. Okay, I'm gonna do I'll do the volumes ones first because they're a little more simple. It's really easy to do the volume and it's totally okay to change it on the fly, you know? And like, so, let's see how that works. Rebase only after you've tried it on another test repo? Right? And yeah, it's a very valid point for sure. So maybe what I'll do is I'll do the music and the sound first, and then I'll try out two different options. One, you know, being able to having to restart. Well, no matter what, you have to restart to change the windowed mode. I don't know. We'll try both. What's up, P and Wally? Yeah, see if you like it or not. Nice, man. Will Slungaroo be able to change controllers on the go without going to the menu? Yeah, totally. Right now, there is a problem with that if you plug in a different controller that you haven't used before. But yeah, if you're using the keyboard and you plug in a controller that you've already mapped right now, the game works fine. You can start using that controller. The Wii control. Yeah, I know, right? For playing retro games. So I'm thinking about how this is implemented with the left and right. Think it might have to might be smarter to add a different this callback for left and right choices. I guess I could just. I need to separate this out into two kinds of code. So one is for the keyboard menu is like this its own beast. And then else we'll do a different menu. So if choices dot size is less than 26, the number of letters in the alphabet, then we do this default mode, which will go up or right or up and down only. Hey, what's up, PMC? Can you play with your racing wheel controller? I don't know. You should try it. Is restarting the game mandatory for changing the window? Yes. No, maybe it's actually not if no, yeah, it totally is. It totally is. No matter what, they have to restart the game to change their windowed mode. Yeah, it's just the way that the game has to start up with the way Cocos 2DX, the game engine's written. What? The debug folder? What, for Visual Studio? Now you need to play with your drum kit. Huh. All right, so if we release the button up. Step equals negative one. But not left. Down. Step's always going to be one. Input did release button down or elapse. Input button down. And we have a callback. You don't necessarily need a callback. There we go. And this is going to be the keyboard menu. It's a special menu which has left and right. So I'm just making this all a little bit more simple to understand for me for later. You know, simpler code's always better. Oh, stream freeze like a. Oh man, sorry, I've been talking here for a minute and the stream was frozen. Oh, it looks like it's okay. Usually when it's totally broken, it'll like flash this the stream icon. And it will also reconnect so that the stream is running shorter than the record recording. So it looks all right. I'm not blinking. Maybe I was just staring. Then maybe a launcher would be a good choice. You won't need to enter the game and restart it. I don't know. What, why would you want that as opposed to just running the game, changing your choice, and then restarting? Yeah, right, the fan. It was Twitch. I know. Right? Fix it. Yeah, Pedro, every time. Okay, so this is where we actually move the cursor. And next, I want to also implement left and right. Yeah, so left and right, that's not that hard. If we release the button left, and and the current choice. That's choices. Choices? Choices, current choice. Dot option callback is not null. Then we just run the option callback. With this, and right is going to be false. Right, it was right, not left. Ink, yeah, so ink is going to be right. Okay, so that's false. You hate launchers? I hate launchers too. Cool. All right, good. I'm glad. I hate launchers too, completely. Oh no. Yeah. All right, cool. So, choices, current choice, object callback, this true. There. So this is move up, down, change option left, right. Okay, cross your fingers. Does this even works? Oh, I guess it would need a different option callback too. Okay, we need to set those up. Game mode menu, settings menu. Because we need a different call. Oh, we can just get rid of these regular callbacks. Actually, I'll start with just the music and sound options. So C dot option callback, bool ink. Cool. So we're here. We can actually change the whatever your option is for music. Let's log something out. We change music setting %D. If we're inking, that would be a +1. Otherwise, it would be a -1. So I can see in the log if this works. Hey, what's up, Zynger? Welcome to the stream. Today, I'm working on the settings menu, so you can finally be able to change your windowed mode and your music volume, your sound volume, and other stuff. Bad function call. What did I do? So I pressed like a random key. Oh. That was some really dumb code. Did you guys see that problem right there? I forgot to put the right button. So if we did release button right, and choice is current choice, option callback's not null. Yeah. Oh crap, this really doesn't need to be like that. It should be like this first. There. Simpler. Less coupled. What's that called? What's good code called when it's not coupled? I know it's called decoupled, but what's the actual term for good code that's decoupled? You're drowning? Why are you drowning, man? You need a floaty. You need some arm floaties. Fast. Stat. Dry? Is that what it's really called? You saw it, Hardboiled? It's called uncooked spaghetti. Alright, so I should be able to press left and right. I just press left and right a bunch. Let's go back to the console. I don't have any look, it worked! It worked! Change music setting -1, -1, -1, blah, 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 blah. All right, yes. Now all we got to do is get it to change the option and also reflect that it changed the option. So we need a music setting and a sound setting, first of all, and they should be defaults. So the game starts with music volume 10, sound volume 10. Is that right? I kind of think that maybe it should be a def. Well, because basically, if somebody messes up their settings file, and let's say they didn't have that in their settings file, then the music, then there would be no music or sound in the game, which would freak some people out. So if I make it opposite, so music volume 0, no, that would be really confusing though. I guess if there's technically no music volume setting, then it could just load 10 by default. Yeah, I can work this, so this is still clear. Yeah. It's called better. I know there's a name for it. There's some official term for. What's that called? Decoupling, coupling in computer programming. Cohesion, that's what it's called. Cohesion. Cohesion means good code, basically. It means your code is not coupled. And coupling means that you've basically written the same function twice. Bad thing, always a bad thing to do. The good thing to do is to take your tiny little code and put it in a function that you can reuse. That's called cohesion. Did we all learn a word there? Don't repeat yourself. Exactly. Steve already said it. Nice. I'm thinking the music volume is going to be one is 0 through 10. And the sound volume is also 0 through 10. Is that cool with everybody? So a dry kiss? Or should it be music volume 100, sound volume 100? I just think that's kind of like a few. Are you ever really going to go change your volume to be 93? You know, won't you just go down to 9 and 8? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's cool. Music volume 10. Unless you guys are really opposed to that, which can totally open to that. Okay, so when it loads the settings, we need to do something special. If it doesn't have a music setting, don't really care. 100 for more resolution. Just to have it. But you don't really care. Save path, get settings. Yes, sometimes you do. You really do. Okay, I mean I could definitely change it to be 100. Oh, here it is. Load settings. Oh, of course, it's got the default settings, blah 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 blah. You probably just adjust your system volume. Will it matter? Not really. You probably won't even be able to hear the difference between 95 and 90. As in for the code? I guess no. Yeah, I guess in the code it wouldn't actually matter. That's a good point. So yeah, we could just do 0 or 100, 100. Sure. It won't matter for the code. Okay, good point. All right, so set default volumes if missing. So if get this is going to be a integer setting for the key music volume dot size. Oh no, dot. No, I guess I need the string setting version. So if we don't even have the string, then set the string. Const string val. 100. And I'll test this out. Are people going to edit this file that often? Hopefully not. I mean, this is not really intended for most people to ever edit. 0 to 11 sounds like the best range. Technically, if it's 0 through 10, then 10 actually is 11. Oh, in the end, I will only encrypt this your actual game. So, right, once the game is finally released, even through beta, I'm going to keep it totally open. So you guys can go just seriously just hack your game, your save games. But then later, once the game is released, this part, all your settings will still be totally text. And then this, only this will be encrypted, your actual save game data. And I think it will be some simple, it won't even technically be encrypted. It will just be base 36 or something like that. So if you really wanted to hack it, you could. That would change. That would make the leaderboard. In the end, the leaderboard is going to be kind of a cool thing, right? So if I don't encrypt this stuff, then some people could easily hack their save game and get a perfect score. So yeah, I really do need to encrypt this eventually. Or do some other kind of like secure verification of people's scores. I don't know. Hey, what's up, Lith? Why not put the settings in its own file? Because I was always going back and forth from these two different files, and it was hell on my mind to go switch context all the time from the settings file back to the game save file. So in the end, it's just going to look something like this. Your save data is going to be like all this crap here you can't read, and this will be like that. And really, in the end, I don't think it will matter to players, so I'm just making it easier on myself. Okay, so we should run this, and it should give me a save or a music setting and a sound volume setting. Then how will we be able to cheat? You won't be able to cheat, that's the point, right? You won't be able to cheat in the final release version because, well, I guess, man, it would be cool. It would be best if I could find a way to allow players to cheat, but if they are cheating, then to not update the leaderboard. That would be the ultimate solution, right? That's all I care about is just the leaderboard being something actually, you know, that people can rely on, like, It's not the leaderboard's not getting hacked. Oh, so that should have just gone and give me the music volume. Oh. I guess we have to write the settings. Anybody going to GDC? Yeah, I'll be there. Not actually at it, but I'll be at some parties afterwards and stuff. But yeah, we can hook up, man. Want to say hi? Hardboiled be good. Don't allow cheating. That's no fun. That's a good point, right? It is less fun if you cheat. Did I manage to fix your... Yes, Arcane, I did. I've halfway fixed your bad seed. It wasn't really your bad seed. I mean, it was just because it was the word arcane. But yes, I fixed the actual half of the issue. So here's the original screenshot, right? Where it had some water right here that you couldn't walk past. So I fixed it. So at least you can walk past this part right here. But there's now a second problem. The second problem is that technically the world or the level number one is behind these level number two gates. So I need to come up with a better solution that's even more comprehensive, that makes sure that levels, I probably have to do some A-star pathfinding to make sure that the pathway to every level is always behind a gate that is still accessible in that level. So basically, if you're going to level one along this path, then it will only make sure this is like a level one gate, which would be the sword growback tile, like thicket-y gate thing. So yeah, there's basically, it's halfway fixed. And hopefully that will be one of the things I push up to the Steam repo. Hopefully tonight. I'd like to be able to get a push up tonight. You're going to attend the expo? Sweet, man. Right on. A crypto signature that checks, but then maybe that's more code. Just easier probably detective. Ah, right, yeah. If detective mods are enabled, then a malformed save file. Mm-hmm. Maybe you could allow loading a non-encrypted save for local use. Yeah, right? Yeah, I like that, Steve. That's a good blend. It would kind of almost enable a beta mode in the release build. That's cool. Yeah, some people can't help themselves cheat, right? Yeah. Yes, Lith, I will be around. Let's hook up for sure. You can grab some tea or a beer or some scotch or some pizza, something. If you must allow cheats, just include some cheats you have to type in. Ah, that's cool. And if one's enabled, you can just deactivate it. I like that. That's really awesome. That's like old school Nintendo style. So this time I run the game, it should give me a music volume and a sound volume. Like that fast, it should already be done. Damn it. Didn't work. Let's see what's going on here. Nice, right on. Man, once again, thank you all for just, I love doing this live stream and making this game. It's so cool to be able to bounce these ideas off you guys and get such great instant feedback. This is such a great way to develop games. I mean, it's difficult to be able to learn how to talk and code and make your game, but like once you get past that, it's a really great thing to be able to just talk to people and get this all this direct feedback. It's so great. You're for allowing cheats. It's their choice in the end. I like that. Yeah, I like the world seed screen. The idea that was actually presented months and months ago was that there would be a special cave where it would be the Game Genie cave, like your old school Nintendo Game Genie, where once you get in this special cave, it's secret, you find this special cave, and inside there, you can enter in cheat codes. So you would enter in some cheat code somehow. I'm not sure how you would do it, but like probably just letters. You just type in letters on the screen or something. I don't know. And then it would enable cheats in there. Is Clift San Francisco good? What is that? What is the Clift San Francisco? Hello, Happy Moose. Or mustache for Jib. There is actually going to be an item you can find to give him a mustache. So what do we got? Key. Music volume, debug only false, set return, empty string, set save game key val, so the val we're trying to set, it's 100. This is 0.musicVolume. Sets the value in the tree. Music volume 100. No children. The saves val tree is It's got nine children. There should be an eighth one. Oh, maybe there's not. Maybe it already had. Oh, yeah, because it was zero. There's zero children, 15. Should be a 14. Yeah, music volume. It's got it here in the tree. It just hasn't flushed it. But I did execute this flush save game command, I'm sure. Saves.save. There, it should have the music volume. Oh, because I'm probably editing the wrong file. What file is this? Show in Finder. Oh no, that definitely is the debug saves.txt. What? Music volume, where are you? Oh, it added it to the end, no wonder. Oh, it put it as a save game key val. Oh, I'm an idiot. I wanted to put it in the settings, not that. Duh. Okay, this is wrong. Soundball. All right, so this is supposed to go in settings. Get string setting. Metroid passwords. Oh, it's a really ho expensive hotel. Oh yeah, there. San Francisco is actually a pretty expensive place. Yeah, if you want some more budget solutions, you should look at the East Bay. But you do have to BART over, which means it's going to take you like half an hour to 45 minutes to get over to San Francisco every day. But you can stay in the East Bay, which is like Berkeley, Oakland, and all these other places over here in the East Bay. They're not quite as nice and awesome as San Francisco, and they are farther away, but they're going to be cheaper. The weird bridges. Oh yeah, please, yeah, add a Trello item for that. I know about that, but there hasn't been a Trello item yet. So thank you for posting that on Trello. That would be awesome. Got set int setting. Guess we need a set string setting and a set float setting. And bool, I guess where we'll add it. These are all necessary. Right, I'm gonna get that compiling, go back to game, and write these other methods which are just kind of missing. This is going to be game set. Already had this method anyways. Get in, set in setting. Right, hopefully that works. Nice, thanks, Hardboiled. So I'm just refactoring this so I can reuse this method 4 times. Yeah. Saves, get child. Take a settings key. Oh, that's like settings Mac or settings Windows. Yeah. Okay, set setting. Get child key. If sib is null, saves get child. Settings key, add child. Otherwise, sib equals stir. Set in setting. Set setting. Key ss.stir. There. Cohesive code! The Mega Man Matrix of Dots password? I forget what those look like. Oh, right. That would actually would be a cool way to input passwords inside a cave, right? So cool. I like that. And it's kind of cool because it's visual. You can remember it. Hopefully. All right, let's do these other methods. Set bool setting. Set float setting. And set string setting, which is the easiest one of them all. Just are called straight to set setting. Inspiration, come up with your own unique Jib-esque version. Yeah, totally inspiration. Hack the refill station? Oh, now that would be a cool way to do it in the refill station. You know what's one really cool like glitch I would actually like to kind of put into the game purposefully? Is I like this glitch in the original Zelda where if you stand on the very edge of the screen and you quickly look up and then step to the right and you're exactly 5 pixels away from the edge of the screen, you can walk from one edge of the screen to the other. It's like a total glitch in the game and it's an exploit people use to speed run faster. I mean, maybe not that exact glitch, but like it might be fun to have a glitch like that. Maybe even that exact glitch. I don't know. I'm sure there will be glitches just in the game anyways, though. You know, no, despite all the bugs that get fixed, I'm sure there will be a few awesome exploits you can do. I should still have a breakpoint. I don't need this breakpoint. I lost my other breakpoint. Oh, well. All right, here, let's check that. You seen that glitch? When you walk through rooms, you walk from one edge of a room to another. You like actually walk off the screen to the right and you walk back onto the same exact screen without even changing screens. You just walk back onto the other side. It's called the Zelda screen scroll glitch. There's even tutorials on how to do it. Yeah, it's called screen scrolling. Yeah. Yep. Totally. That's the one. All right, cool. The build finally is built. Check this out. All right, we should have no music volume setting. Good. And now, after setting this in setting, flushing the save game. Music volume 100. Yay. And then again, flush save game. We should have sound volume now. What happened to the sound volume? Boo. Oh, I'm gonna look at this. I'm making some funny mistakes today. Oh, really? You could do that with Link's Awakening? Wow. Oh, the Game Boy one. Ah. Did not know they had that. Okay, so now I just got to make it so pressing left and right here changes the actual number that's displayed there. Title screen, scene. Title screen, scene. So menu settings, music. Let's get the current setting. Game get. In setting. Music volume. Val equals clamp by. Val plus inc. 10, negative 10. So I'm gonna start it off so the menu setting screen just does 1 through 10, but you will be able to actually change it manually in the settings file if you really want to. Clamp that between 0 and 100. Game set int setting, music volume, val. All right, and then we want to update this thing, this option. Dang, how do I update the option? It's got a, I got a label for it. You all right? A one-time glitch? What's up, Roiku? Is your game ever done? Nope, it won't be done for at least a number of months into the future. But this year it will definitely be done. 2016, Songbringer's coming out. The beta's coming up February 21st, by the way, Roiku. So if yeah, if you want to play it, you can pre-order songbringer.com, pre-order. A one-time glitch, yeah. How do I get the current choice? I guess I could just capture. Oh no, it would be choices. I would have to look through the current choices. Looking for this text. That's kind of janky, but it would be really the only way I could do this right now. Right? Or I guess I could look through the. No. You know what? An integer ID would really help here. Maybe even a number. No, an ID would be better. Gotta recompile again. Damn, it's been a lot of recompiling today. Okay, so choices by default. Oh. Stop it there, because recompile that with equals zero. All right, so I can set an actual ID. C.id equals one. Or I could do a quick enum. Option music, sound, window. First one's one. C.id equals k option window. This is so it can find itself later. Music and sound. Window. Okay, yeah. So music can now find itself so it can loop through. Loop through all the choices. If choice dot ID equals K option music, then we've got the current choice and we can go change its. It's text. Do a string stream. And give the actual volume number. So it's going to be val divided by 10. We'll L round F that. Hey, what's up, Platformer Labs? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the stream. Today I'm working on the menu, so I'm adding in some options so you can change your music volume, your sound volume, your windowed mode. And hopefully I'll be able to push some of these changes up to the Steam version tonight. I'm not promising anything, but I'm also going to get better about the Steam, what I push up there too. So I'm thinking that on the Steam, I should every time I update to Steam, I should actually release a little update. So that you guys can see what changed. Like it will actually be some news, like a news entry on the Stormbringers Steam page or whatever. So like it'll be a tiny little update. It's like, okay, I pushed a new update. Here's a couple of the new things that changed. So that way if you're right on Steam, you can just see like quickly what's changed or not. I think Steam is pretty friendly about that, right? Yeah, there will definitely be a change log too, but I'm thinking like that it might be nice to be able to see the actual changes. Right? So when you because when you like there's a certain mode of Steam you can get into. My God, Steam's all messed up. Updates. No. Yeah, here is view Songbringer update history. If you do that, it just goes and gives you the news. So I'm thinking that every time there's an update, there should be some news. Or is that cool? Right. All right, cool. Otherwise, the other option is I could just keep like I will keep a change log anyways, but you would the other option is I would have you would have to go into the you would go into your game's files and you would have to just see the change log. Right? So you go to your local files. Browse local files, and there would be like a changelog file that you would have to go manually check each time. But I think it would be more friendly, right? Wouldn't it for you guys to be able to see those changes right here on the updates. I think there's actually an updates. Yeah, right here, recent news. So in recent, every time you it was an update, you'd probably be able to see in the first like paragraph that, you know, what it was, what was changed. Update the news. All right, cool. Yes, you do. You have a lot more playtime, but I probably technically have a lot more playtime than I definitely have a lot more playtime than 2 hours. This is just what's logged in on Steam. I'm most of the time when I'm playing the game, I'm here in my debug mode, which doesn't log hours to Steam or whatever. So this is just hours that I've played while only on the release build, you know, which I typically just go in and try and check pretty cursorily, quickly. Nice. Okay, I'll put that on the news. Every time there's an update, I'm thinking like one update a week or something like that, maybe. And then, yeah, I'll put some news up and just share what's new each time. This should work now. Should be able to update the option. Oh, wait. Forgot to set it. Choice.text equals ss.stir. And choice.label not equal to null. Choice.label set string ss.stir. Great person is now playing Clicker Heroes. It's nice to know. Okay, let's see if that worked. This would be nice. Have this all set to go. Music options. Volume options, finally. Finally doing it right on the settings menu. The next big menu I'll have to do is the leaderboard menu. That will be, that'll be fun. We don't have a volume yet. Oh. Hey, it works. But it doesn't actually set the volume yet. Okay, so now we need to just make it so it sets the right string. We're using a callback so we can, once again, write some cohesive code. I think I have a bot foo updated now. Hey, sweet. Thanks, Boogie. That's cool. Yeah, so we need a little function. Auto set music string, something like that. Given a choice. No. A regular choice ref. Choice ref. Choice. Oh, and also the value. No, we'll just get the current value. Easier that way. Hey, what's up, Turticus? All right, cool. Next stream. Right on. Music string. We're getting the music prefix. Adding in the current value, which we want to be. Game. Get. Int setting. Music volume. Choice.text equals that, choice.label. Yeah, all good. All right, so now we can go set music string, given our choice here. Boom, that's done. And then capture this other thing, set music string. See if that worked. So if this works, It'll have the music's volume shown there, and then when changing it, it will also change it. Yes, all right. We started with a volume of 10. Sweet. Let's leave it at 7. Exit, start again, make sure that 7 is still there. And also that should be 70 in the save. Oh, it didn't save it. Aha. Okay, one more problem. Game set in setting. Game flush. Save game. Flush, save game. Cool. Glad that worked. Great. Now we've got a method we can use for setting the sound volume as well. But, oh, first I need I now last I need to make sure it changes the actual volume of this the music. I think there's a set music volume function. Well, I got a better idea. Kit should have a set, it should have its own global vault music volume and global sound effect volume that applies to every single, yeah. That's the best way to do this. So, yeah, there's a set volume and a set music volume for each for the set volume is for sound effects, set music volume is for music. But overall, there should also be a global enable sound, enable music. Set global music volume. Set global sound volume. Once again, we're recompiling everything. It's been kind of a lots of recompiles today. All right, set music volume. Set these globals to start at 1. Global music volume, global sound. All these do is just set it. Hell, I don't need to make two copies of this. Or do I? Now I might possibly need to. Oh, yeah. Well. Global music, global sound. Okay. When the game starts now, we need to set whatever the music volume is. game, Gideon setting. Times 1/100. I guess it'd just be more clear if I wrote divided by 100 there. Yeah. Cool. So now we're setting the default. This is the music volume. Set global. Set global. Yeah, that looks good. All right, and now actually back in the kit, when it sets the global music, actually when it plays a sound effect, it just needs to multiply the volume by the global. Oh. Let's clamp that, clamp FO1. Yeah, this has kind of gotten ridiculous duplicating this code. Just gonna make that one function. Enable sound, disable sound, same thing. Cool. All right, so when we play, oops. What did I do wrong? Wake up, chat. No. Are you guys asleep? Sorry about the late stream today. Oh, I guess it worked that time. All right. So now when we play a sound, we need to make sure the volume is multiplied. Global sound volume. And the music, same thing. Play music does not set the volume. Okay. Set volume though. Vol equals. I'll just vol times equals global sound volume. Same thing with music. Global music volume. Using underscores as the first character in your variables? Isn't that against the C++ rules? Kind of. But what I'm using this for is to kind of indicate a private without having to put the private inside the kit's header. It's bullshit to have to recompile your entire 60-file source code just because you're changing a few variables that no one else should ever know about. So that's why I do that. This is just a convention, a naming convention, which helps me to remember that this is a static, kind of a private, technically like a, I said really it's a private, kind of. Yeah. I'm not doing it. I'm not taking part in this war. All right, so back in title scene, we should be able to set the music volume now. kit, set global music volume to be val over 100. And we also need to set the actual music volume to be 1.0. Whatever's playing. I think that's, I can pass an empty string there. If f.si is less than or equal to 0, yeah. Okay, let's see if this works. If you can unmod yourself. Oh, this whole time I didn't even have these plugged in. Did that update game show? Yeah, we got sound. Good, alright. Okay, so I'm gonna go into the settings, set my music volume. Nice! Glitch mode! Okay, so I'm gonna set it really quiet like this. And then if I go into a game, it should fade out, and it should fade out the sound, the music. Yes, good. So it went from like 10% down to 0 there. Oh, there's one thing though. It doesn't consider... now I need to get global volume. Because it doesn't consider the ambiences are actually sound effects, not music. So, now I need to get global music volume function. One more recompile. Here we go. Kit.h. It is working! Set global music volume. I should have just written this before I recompiled. There we go. Volume controls between 0 and 1. Do you really want... I can make it 1 through 100 on the actual settings screen. Pimple idiom? Yes, I've heard of the pimple idiom. Lunar Melt. Yeah, it's a great thing. It would accomplish what you're doing with static bars, but it's far too tedious in the game, but I like your solution. Yes. Yeah, I've heard of Pimple. I've used it once in a project where, you know, I was writing the real-time multiplayer game, the last one I made, Hero Bash, and there was, like, this giant-ass library we had to include to do our networking, and I used the Pimple idiom to make sure I could abstract that away inside of one source file rather than every source file having to include this giant library. Can you change the volume from in-game? That's what I was doing. Did any NES or SNES games ever let you adjust volume? Did they? That's a good question. Which ones? Get set. Oh, whoops. Get global music volume. Get global sound volume. Good. All right. So now we can get those. And the music system itself. Music System. When it plays, fades music, it calls set volume. It's kind of crazy, but I'm gonna have to invert a few things. So volume divided by the global sound volume. So I need to unapply global sound and apply global music. Oh, during the actual gameplay. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. That's what I'm doing right here. So it didn't actually change the volume in the game because the ambience is working a different way. So I have to write this extra code to make sure it applies the right volume to the ambient music, which is technically a sound effect. Yeah, what Boogie said about what Pedro said. So yeah, we want to divide by kit gate global sound volume and then multiply by music volume and then pass that into kit sound volume or set volume, and then that will that will then apply the global sound volume, which was unapplied already. Yeah, that will work because it doesn't actually apply any clamping. This only works here because of the clamping. No, it would work without the clamping, as long as I clamp the end result. Mm-hmm. There's a couple, I think there's some more places where we set volume. Yeah. This is 1.0. Same thing though. Flood volume 1.0. All right, let's see if that worked. Every time I say clamp, I think of Futurama. Why is that? Was that guy? Did that guy say that? I didn't watch enough Futurama. Oh. Dirt. Dirt. Derp a derp. All right, so hopefully this time, yeah, we got a nice quiet volume to start with, which is, we can confirm, yeah, our music volume is all the way down to 10. Okay, so you can tell this, the, yeah. Set it back to 1. Let's go play a game. And now the ambience should also be quiet. Yes, it is. Oh, cool. I'm on the master branch. Yes, I love this old master branch and fun branch thing. So cool. Awesome. Now let's go. Let's check one more thing. Let's set the music volume all the way to zero. Definitely can't hear anything. Let's go in the game and make sure all those are totally quiet. Can't hear any of this. Yeah. Awesome. We got a music setting. Clamps. 0 to 10 works great. Cool. Well, it's gonna be 0 to 10 in the menu, but in the actual save game, you can actually go all the way to 100. So, hopefully, that's the best of both worlds. But you can actually go from 0 to 255. 0.0 to 1.0. Oh, Tranby. I like the way you're thinking on that. Yeah, I like Tranby. I like Tranby's solution actually. That's really cool. Where in the actual save game, it would be very, very cool to have 0 and 1. And then just whatever the heck it is in the game. That's what you suggested earlier? Oh, sorry, Boogie. No, I'm listening to you because that's a great solution. I like that a lot. So in the game, set up the defaults. Music volume 1.0, sound volume 1.0. Make sure it enforces that. Get float setting 1.0F, and then this is gonna be game get float setting music volume. See, this is a lot easier. Simpler code. It's still gonna be 0 through 10 on the menu for now. all right, so let's make sure every reference to music volume is still correct. It's gonna be set float setting for float val over 100. Oh, this can just be easier now too. It's inc of 1, negative 1 between 0 and 10. And then divide that by 10. Flush the save game. Set the global music volume to game. Get float setting. Music ball. Okay, let's make sure everything still works. So I'm gonna delete these. No stop with the Tramby train. I know, right? Yeah, where's Scottish Pizza and Rocket Bunny? It's probably late for those guys. Probably late for all y'all. Oh, okay, messed up. Oh, that's because it's just the visual right here. So this should be get float setting. Get gloat setting? Get float setting times 10. And it should have music volume 1, sound volume 1. All right, cool. 3 a.m. It's late for you guys. Oops. Okay, so editing is bad now. Oh. Right. Float val. Get float setting, music volume. Clamp F val plus ink. This is gonna be clamp F01. Also simpler than set float setting val. Also simpler. And then also down here, we can just go val. All more simple. See, that took a second, but in the end, I think this is a little more simple. The night is young. I know pizza sounds good. Oh. It's almost 5 a.m. there, right? Dude. Hey, look, it worked. All right, so let's go back and do the same test. Like, that should be... Now, actually, in my save file, I should say 0.1. Good. And when I run the game, it should, the ambience music should be quiet. It is. Cool. Let's hook up the sound volume now. So we need a set... Set music volume or set sound string. Menu settings sound. Sound volume. Set sound string for C. Oh, this is going to be option callback. No, that's right. Oh, just go set surround screen. C. There. Sound volume, flush save game, set sound string. If it's option sound, set the sound string, set global sound volume. I'm going to review all this too, make sure I just typed all that right. Slovakia, Portugal, Israel. Mars Power Future. You from Chile? Cool. UK. Set sound string, get localized menu settings sound, sound volume, option sound, set sound string, option callback, sound volume, sound volume. That should be good. It's like the other side of the pillow. Oh, you're not really? Oh. Unreal, what's up, man? I will be a Googler after my uni. You mean you're working at Google? Just got my feedback on the set of interviews today. Whoa, good for you, dude. I guess the month was not that bad in balance then, right? Yeah, totally. Oh man, that sucks. Sorry to hear that. Well, wow, where are you working at? What Google office are you gonna be at? Whoa, you see this? Look at this. How did that happen? Oh, I think you know what it is. All these other IDs. We don't care about. Oh, and also, both of these should have be a little safer. So they, screw it. Cohesion. Oh, in the London office. Right on. Dude, you're gonna get paid really well, I'm sure. Google is a great company to work for. From what I hear, I've never worked for Google or anything, but let's keep the music volume really low. We'll keep the sound volume low as well. So you just barely hear stuff. Yep, it's pretty quiet. Good. Let's go and change it to even all the way down. We should have no sounds whatsoever but a tiny bit of music. They are our future overlords. Oh, they could be. Wasn't there supposed to be a little bit of music? Yeah, there was, huh? Yeah, so I think we found a bug. Okay, so we've got music volume 0.1, but sound volume 0. Okay, so that two those two adjustments I made to do like a quasi music volume here in Music System. Yo, what's what? I don't need PBX. The file, the Carbon Core, right? Dude. I wish this quick open was better in Xcode. All right, so set volume. If the volume Oh, so this is going to be global sound volume no matter what. Oh, we need a man, we need a different method then. We need some kind of method that's like set the quasi music volume. Set the music volume if it were as if it were a sound effect. Sound adjusting should boop. It does. Yes, it does. It was booping there. Or maybe the boop should be louder. Yeah, all for booping. Yeah, nice. Yeah, that's why I think it's okay to keep it only in the settings and not something you actually can adjust while you're in the actual. When you're playing, you're actually in a world. Yeah, all right. So, all right, let's get something compiling. We need a different method, a smarter method for setting set volume of music effect. This is a quasi set volume. So you give your sound ID and your flow volume, and it figures it out for you. It's probably a bad name, but I can easily change it later. 2 hours and counting? All right. Well, we're about to be shut down here, but I'm going to finish this before we go. So I'm just going to make this little function that's like the same thing as this set music volume, but works with ambiences, basically. Set music volume. I need to copy this function here. Set volume for music effect. Stomach setting. Yep, it's a growl. No way. Oh, I love you guys. So funny. Why is it erroring on this one? That wasn't so hard. It's a simple method, actually. And then music system. Now we can call this better method. Set volume of music effect. It's like a quasi effect. All right. He used the Isaac with tears emote. That's a real please right there. So this time when we run it again in the game, it should have no sound effects, but small music effect. All right, yeah, it worked. We have no sound effects, but the music is very quiet. Now let's go and turn the music up a bit, like all the way. So this time it should have loud music, no sound effects. Good. Yeah, that's Isaac. Never played it? Which one should you, if you play one, I think you should play the Rebirth one, personally. Yeah, I like the what do you guys think? Hardboiled has like 250 hours on it. So what do you think, Hardboiled? What's better, Binding of Isaac or Rebirth? Oh, I see, it isn't booping. You guys are totally right. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, let's make it boop. Boop, 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 boop. Title air, title scene. Boop, boop the sounds. Boop them real good. Dialogue open. $250 hours on the new one and about 100 on the original. Rebirth is awesome. Yeah, I agree. I totally agree. Yeah, Boogie, if you want to play, I always just thought it was some gelatinous blob creature. That's Isaac, man. That is Isaac from Binding of Isaac. What do we got here? Still not booping. Why not boop? I like booping. It's cool. What's up with the boop, yo? Oh, because I put it on the music volume. Derp. Derp it, derp a derp. Yeah, right. I like this sound better for booping. Let's get that. Which one is that? It's not. I think it's called Move Cursor. Oh, it's just called Cursor. Sometimes giant blood lasers. He's got a ton of weapons in that game. And what's so cool about Binding of Isaac is you can combine all of your weapons together. Cool, now we got some booping. Is that loud enough? Loud enough boop? Probably. I don't know. So let's make sure that I mess around with the settings of the volume and it's all good in the game. Yeah. Whoops! Invalid id on removing components. What is it trying to destroy? Oh, see, it's still updating the tick. Oh, you know what probably just happened? I was shooting off the fire and it was creating all these fire entities and stuff. And after it runs for a certain time, it goes and then it deletes the entity. But when you're actually exiting the game, it already automatically deletes all the entities for you. So you really would need to clear any. I'm gonna note this on Trello for later because this is not something I'm gonna fix right now. This is kind of a really obscure bug that some people might get sometimes. So, handle. Ensure that after update and before tick funks. Clear out any, or something like this, if they're cleared when clearing the whole scene, exiting the game. That's probably not something people are going to experience very often, but at least I got a clue for. Let's make that one yellow, I guess. The particles? You've seen these particles before. Have you made a fire sword before? Right? The screen scrolling? Yeah. Particles. They shouldn't be landing on the sky, and I do have some code that can fix that really easy. And I've got a Trello already for that. The fire sword is pretty rad. Can really work some great damage if you hit, especially these guys. These are really weak to the fire. So let's play around with the sound a little bit. Just do one last check, make sure this is working. Yep, my sound effects are quieter. Now they should be super quiet. Yep. All right. Okay, so that's it for today's stream. So for tonight, I'll go and make sure that the window, you can change the window setting to, it'll probably say something like restart is required if you've, if you've actually done it, you know? Yes, I do have weaknesses implemented, but oh, they're not actually applied though. It's in the code, so enemies can have weaknesses to like fire or ice or whatever, but I just haven't hooked that up to the enemies yet. That'll require some overall tweaking and balancing and design decisions. And really, I need a lot more enemies in the world to be able to make those kind of decisions. So until I get a bunch more enemies in, actually, as I add more enemies, I'll start adding little flags like that, like this guy's fire weak, this guy's ice weak, or whatever. The fire sword, yeah, it's in there. Yeah, so you combine, oh, hardboiled, should I tell you? Or should I let you figure it out? You want me to tell you how to do it, or do you want me to? Because I can totally tell you, but I recognize that if you want to figure it out for yourself, then yeah. Only cool people can have it. Okay, good. So yeah, all the sounds have changed nicely, dynamically. Alright, cool. I'll let you figure it out. Alright, so yeah. I'll see you guys tomorrow or something. If you guys are around, I'll be back streaming tomorrow. I'll be working on something else, I'm sure. I'm gonna try and do an update to Steam tonight, if I have enough time. We'll see. I gotta fix a few more bugs too, but yeah. So yeah, hope you guys had a good time watching, and yeah, be back tomorrow. Hope you guys have a great night.